I will speak about Foxtrot because I'm a little bit angry because I don't see real Foxtrot anymore in competition. Many couples thinking about dynamic and running a little bit. So we have a lot of habits and we don't have a lot of fashion, and we have to separate these things with a pure Foxtrot. And with my demonstration couple, the world champion Dima and Olga, I think we will send a very good message to make all the young students understand what is the right thing and what we have to do in Foxtrot. I want to speak a little bit about Foxtrot because when I watch competition, when I go through many competitions, I get a little bit angry. Why? Because I cannot see so many Foxtrots anymore. I see a lot of waltz trots or running Foxtrots. And I understand that we are in 2016 and we have a lot of fashion steps, and which is totally correct. And this should be like this. And also we dance not in two dimensions anymore. We dance in three dimensions in this time. But anyway, when we go back in our routines, when all couples go back in the routines to normal basic or semi-basic steps, I need to see Foxtrot. And to understand what is Foxtrot, I would like to do some Latin bye-bye. Yeah. I would like to show you some ideas or some general principles which are very important for Foxtrot in basic steps. And for this, to understand my words even better, I found a couple which is not that bad with this. And please welcome, yeah, for demonstration, the world champion, Dimitri Zharkov, Olga Kunikova. So, when we speak about Foxtrot, I would like to introduce the whole package with a little bit Foxtrot basic. Yeah, Dima, is it possible that you show just that we speak all together from the same thing? Very good. Dima, one more time from here. Very nice. And this is very, very difficult, especially it's 5 to 10. Well done. For this time, super excellent anyway. So,
it looks quite easy, yeah? Looks easy. Okay. So, I just want to explain a little bit a package. What is inside the principles? Can you see the result? Yeah, isn't it all so nice, so smart, so smooth? But when you try to do this, it is quite difficult. Olga, can I use it? So I want to go through several points that everybody understands what is important for the Foxtrot. So when I do these type of movements, and I try to, for example, start with a feather step, it is very important that I don't activate my upswinging side. I never work with upswinging sides in Foxtrot. I especially work with downswinging hips or to shorten one side. So we immediately start to shorten our side on one to create on three a shape. What type of swing do we have in Foxtrot? We have in waltz, we have pendulum swing. Just in tango, we have no swing. Yeah? In quick step, maybe sideways, forward, progressive swing. In Foxtrot, I don't like this word so much, pendulum swing or like this. I like more progressive swing. So when I move, yeah, the progressive swing becomes visible from 3 to 4, yeah, plus the landing. Important is that I don't fall in backwards. When you see 10 couples starting with feather step, everybody tries to swing up the left side and goes backwards. The only possibility not to come backwards in feather step is to shorten one side. So when I go on right foot, I shorten my right side to balance on 3, landing on 4. So if you are aware of doing that, one, we shorten, Olga shorten the left side, I'm shortening my right side, we have a sway on 3, and the landing. Yeah, and this is very, very important to understand. Lowering the hip, swaying, landing. Important is when I'm shortening one side on one, that I do not attack and overact the movement on 3. This is very important. So the case is done here. 1, 2, that's it. And we land. Okay? So, Iman, can you please just do a feather step in full hold and finish in high position. So the first package is we shorten the side, shape, and land. Okay. That's it. So if you dance with this structure, with this plan, you must also be careful that this is Foxtrot. You must respect the curve, the general curve of the movement. I said, I don't like Ballroom. I don't like when couples starting with feather step and pressing against the floor on 3. Yeah, landing. Pressing, landing. Pressing, landing. So the movement must be very smart. Means another package. When I start, I feel a little bit, I'm not touching the inside of my legs. So I feel a little bit on a wider track. So I move, yeah, and I don't touch the inside. So I don't go this way, to slip. This is one thing. The more important thing is that I must be able to shake my legs. When I walk on the street and I want to drink a coffee, and there is a coffee shop, so I start up, I go to this coffee shop. I don't think I go to this. So what I do by nature is I curve. Yeah, I go forward, I don't go on the street like this. I want to drink a coffee. Now I drink a coffee. Maybe some people, the information team, yeah? Anyway, we will never do this. We will not walk, not coffee. Okay, we go this way. No, we will curve. It means we shake our legs. When I start with a feather step, I start also to shake my legs to go with the outside heel. I never go with heel or toe. I always use outside or inside, heel and toe. And I try to shake my legs with the curve.
I shape my legs with a curving. I shape my legs with a curving. I shape my legs with a curving. And this means the movement become very, very smart. Very, very smart. So when I start with this, yeah, I shape my legs. I shape my legs. I curve. I curve. I curve. I curve. And this makes the movement very smart and keeps the general line of movement very smart and not pushing up. Dima? So, the package, already three things in the package. First is, sorry, Dima. First is, I just want to repeat. First is lowering the hip, shape, movement, one. Second thing is, we're dancing on a little bit wider track, okay? The third thing is, now they try to shape their legs. Now, sorry. Five, six, seven. Shape, 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 shape. Very good. Very good, very good. So, this makes, maybe to, can I ask you one favor? Can you dance a little bit like 5 years ago? You remember this time? We had a little bit discussion from time to time, yeah?
Wait,
no, yeah? Like a good soldier. So, but don't knock, come on, at least too much. Nah, okay, 4.5 years ago. So 4.5 years ago. So listen, watch now. He goes straight, turning. He goes back, turning. He goes straight. A little bit too much, a little bit too much. But if you see, it's even not that bad. Yeah, it's even not that bad. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, so one more time with a nice curving. So watch now. Watch how he's using the legs in his shape and the hips. So the hip goes down, shortening the side, and through this, the shape is created. I'm landing, compressing in the standing leg. I'm shortening my left side, and the shape is created. Yeah, I shape my leg. I shape my leg. I use my hip, and the movement is created. I'm compressed. I use the standing leg, shortening my left side, curving, and it's created. And this makes the movement this way, a little bit like a snake in the sand. Okay? Especially for you. So you see, the package is, of course, not completed. So I just want to repeat a little bit that you have a good structure, yeah, when you stay desperated at home, yeah, and trying to manage the Foxtrot. So still, we speak about the mechanics. We didn't speak about rhythm, we didn't speak about music at the moment, so just keep this in your mind. Yeah. So one more time, we're lowering the hip, we're dancing with shortening a side. Shortening a side. Shortening a side makes my body possible to transfer in a vertical way. Swinging up a side brings me immediately backwards. No? Listen carefully. This is very, very important. It is, for example, the same in the natural turn. I'm shortening one side, I'm not swinging up. It means I'm separating the swing. Can I use you a little bit with the, yeah? So when I, for example, in natural turn, when I go here and I drive and I want to go this way, yeah? And I swing up, I activating my side, and it's not a smart swing. So this means my knees and my feet must rotate. I rotate my knees and I swing. This is the lower part. Of course, I understand that we have a lot of progression. So if my lower part is rotating and my upper part is passing and she let me pass, of course, we have a separation between down and up. But it's very important that the swing, in which dance ever, is created by feet and knees. This is a natural swing. Everything else, what you see, just a natural turn, making like this, it's a little bit from upper part, which is absolutely legal, but it is a manufactured swing. Manufactured swing is not natural, it's fake. Yeah, it's like a wrong watch. Can look very good, but it's not true. And of course, makes the life in competition very short, because you activating too many muscles and you will lose sooner or later, you will lose your style and you will lose your position. So one more time, we shortening the side, we swinging up. We keep everything on a wide and big track. And we try to curve and shape our legs. Yeah, shaping legs means when I stay here, I must be able to rotate my knees. There is a big, big flexibility. Yeah, so I rotate my knees and move. 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 Makes everything very smart. Everybody, what? Yeah. Better? Yeah. Okay, it's my sister always controlling me. Okay, so, if we have something like that, that we have a construction in our body, that we can stay together, just a little bit, a few words, it's a totally different topic. But of course, all these things are quite easy, not easy, but also difficult, but a little bit more easy when we do something alone. As soon as we have to connect everything in a hold, everything becomes a little bit more difficult. What I want to say about hold, I don't want to go so deep in this, but Olga, can you just stay in your personal position? Yeah. So I don't want to say that the girl is supporting 100% the man. But when you watch this bone, that this bone is completely connected with this wrist. And even when I come together, I feel immediately this side. Can you put this bone or this hip down, Olga? Yeah, naja. Yeah. More hiding, more, just a little bit. Yeah, so a little bit. Yes. So this is already enough, will make my life in competition very short, because I will immediately start to lead a little bit with the left side, because I feel I have to do something. Okay, well, again, as soon as this hip is connected with her right hand, I feel very, very good supported here. I cannot say I can hang on this side, but it's a very strong connection. So, and when you watch just the position. So, okay, they have the habits, but you see immediately that this part is very strong supporting Dima's left side. He, by himself, is leading with his right side. Start. Ta-dap, ta-dap. So leading, shortening the sides, balance.
Shortening the sides, balance. Shortening, balance. Shorten, very good. Yeah, understand? It's very, 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 very important. Okay, so when you think about Foxtrot, what is the main and important, most important thing when you watch on video, how you can identify Foxtrot? With the outside movement, with the feather ending, weave ending, whatever. So the outside, this outside movement is the characteristic movement in Foxtrot, okay? So if you switch off the music and you watch, then you will see, ah, this must be Foxtrot, yeah? And if you switch off the music and you see somebody is doing this, maybe it's wrong waltz, then you have maybe waltz trot. Yeah, so I want to see the Foxtrot. So we set through these mechanics how we manage everything to keep the construction more or less okay. So when I'm shaping my legs and balancing here on three, I'm not static. I continue with the movement. Yeah, this is the wave, and the wave is not finishing. The wave is going through. So when I start, I'm going through. What you maybe not recognize is, when I stay on three, my body is moving, and then I'm landing. One, two, three. One, two. I go back. And I move. So before I'm landing, I'm activating my body. Means. Yeah, a simple exercise. When I close my feet, yeah, and I move my body, I can do a lot without making steps. Yeah, in static position, in static balance, everything is quite easy. As soon as I start in dynamic balance, everything a little bit more difficult, more unstable. So I move my body. Yeah, I feel here is a wall. And before I start my legs, I break this wall. I break this wall, one. I break this wall. I go backwards. I break this wall. Understand? Means, a very good Foxtrot with a high quality must be visible with all these fashion steps. Sooner or later, a couple, when I will judge, will tell me something about the feather ending, about the weave ending. And when I see the leg in front of the body, it's not good. Yeah? I want to see balance, yeah? Not backwards. I want to see balance, and then first the body, then the leg. It's a very nice sentence which I wrote up. The body commands the step. So when I move, one, two, three, the body commands the step. Now I go backwards. The body commands the step. Good luck. So all coaches already working, so be free. Yeah. So check construction, body. We were walking on these steps. Yes. And believe me, and also say this is true, it's really true. We were speaking very often about this, to open this in a competition, but many, many times we said, not good enough, we have to wait a little bit, not good enough, not good enough. It was really, finally he did it, yeah, and it was really good. But if you opening your Foxtrot, or if you do this in a competition, please don't do some steps or some bullshit. Really understand what you are doing. This is the, if you work with these steps, this is the highest level of Foxtrot. I respect all fashion steps, but sooner or later, everybody comes back to the roots. Sooner or later. Yeah, I understand, this is nice, and another shape, and one more wave, and the ship is sinking. Yeah? But, at the end, we come all to the same thing. Yeah? That's it. Yeah? So, now, how to do this? How to be in time on three, and be, and have the time on three to delay and leading. If I want to delay, and I have this time, so I must play inside of this time. I cannot change the time. I cannot say, now somebody in the music will delay and somebody will make it faster. So it's very important that I understand that I have three steps and four beats. And if I have four beats, I must understand where I put my feet. So we have the musically accent in Foxtrot 1, 3, 5, 7. So when I activate, I cannot say I'm hitting the one, but more or less I'm not too late on slow. So when I count, this is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So I cannot be so late. If I'm very late in the music, I must run with my leg. So I have to understand, and this is of course very, very difficult to do this. Yeah, it's very, very difficult to understand how I can manage this. I will show you first how it's wrong. 5, 6. Then when I start too late, now I must run with the leg. Yeah. I must run with the leg. So, but when I put my body on the beat and play with the beat, then I have enough time to play. Yeah, with a 1. That you are in time and in the music. Dima. At the end of the lecture, I want to say one thing. This is the base. If you understand this, if you work seriously with these steps, you will immediately recognize that your choreography will change on a different level. Because your steps, which you will find in your choreography, yeah, maybe not these steps, but you will find a wave, maybe, yeah, you will find heel pull, curved feather, yeah? Maybe you dance a three-step, maybe running three-step. Everything is basic. So you will find these steps in your choreography. In a good Foxtrot, there must be a wave. In a good Foxtrot, there must be a weave. In a good Foxtrot, there must be a feather step. Maybe curved feather step, yeah? Or back feather, yeah? In a good Foxtrot, you need, with all the fashion steps, you need these basic things to demonstrate the characteristic of the dance. The fashion steps are not showing the character. The fashion showing the fashion. This is legal, yeah? We don't wear pullovers from 30 years ago, or shoes, yeah? Everything is changing, yeah? But still, it must fit. I want that you take one part of your choreography, maybe this with a wave, yeah, that we have some fashion and then back to normal, slow, quick rhythm. Yeah? Yeah. Congratulations. So, wow. It's easy. Very nice. It's easy to see. Yeah. It's easy. Can we go through these steps slowly? I just want to explain, only slowly, in practice hold. Yeah. So I just want to explain what you have and finally what will be judged. Some is for pleasure. So we start. Okay, start with this. So here's a nice pivot. Okay, this is a weave. Very nice. A weave. Yeah. Connected weave. Type of pivot. Okay, telemark. Okay, this is change of direction. Okay, now, wait, now he's doing run back cross. And suddenly, we go into basic. So, and these are the interesting moments. Okay, rumba cross is a very normal figure, but of course it's very difficult. It's always very difficult from slow to quick. It's easy to go from slow to quick. It's very difficult to go from quick movement to slow movement. This is asking for quality and control. Can you start with the change of direction and move into the rumba cross? Yara, yararari, dara, da, darira. Understand? And this, finally, rumba cross, everybody will recognize. The feather step will be judged. One more time, the long side with the music. Yes, the same. It will be possible in future to change a little bit the Foxtrot. I don't want to destroy the fashion. I like the fashion, but a little bit more into real Foxtrot, to see Foxtrot. Otherwise, you will see Waltztrot, Foxtrot a little bit wrong, and the new fashion is Viennese Waltz, yeah? Then we have already three Foxtrots, yeah? When we reduce the music in Quickstep, we have already four Foxtrots, yeah? So it should be an individual dance, and it should be with a clear characterization of Foxtrot. Okay? So thank you very much, and at the end, I would like to ask Dima to show some parts of his choreography, yeah, that you feel already stimulated for the camp 2016. No, no, no. No. Yes.
I met a chick the other day. Walking down Old Broadway, our eyes met. I felt a touch. She was, how you say, too much. I love to love, got plenty of love each night. I love to love, it can't be wrong, it must be right. Yes, sir, that's my baby. No, sir, I don't mean maybe. Yes,
fashion.
Sir, that's my baby now. No, ma'am.
Quality.
She's inviting. Yes, ma'am. She's exciting. Yes.
Thank you very much.
That's my.
Thank you very much, Olga and Dima. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you will have a very good camp. You will improve a lot. And in case you have some questions, see you during these 3 days. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Olga. Thank you very much, Dima. Thanks a lot. Ta-da. Oh my God. Ta-da. Thanks a lot. Thank you.